In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主之圣名说话。
First and foremost, I give thanks to our Heavenly Father.
感谢，首先我们感谢天上的阿爸父。
That we are able to gather here online to listen to the Word of God.
那我们能够在线上聚集来聆听神的话。
We understand that today is the blessed day of the Lord.
那我们都知道今天是神所赐福的一天。
We believe that being God's children, and we shall be blessed by Him tremendously on this blessed day.
那我们知道身为神的儿女呢，我们相信神会大大的在这一天来祝福各位。
In the book of Exodus chapter 16,
那在出埃及记第16章告诉我们。
We understand that, you know, on the sixth day, what they have collected is enough to sustain them on the seventh day.
那我们知道他们在第六日所收据的呢，可以让他们在第七日能够来继续来生活。
Meaning that the manna that they have gathered was enough to sustain them on the seventh day.
那就是他们所收集的玛拿呢，他们能够在第七日也能够来足够。
This actually tells us that God is the provider of their daily needs.
那就是告诉我们呢，神是为我们预备日用所需的神。
Today, if we rest on the seventh day,
如果今天我们在第七日来安息。
We are reminded that, you know, God is the provider of our daily needs.
还是提醒自己说呢，神会为我们预备日用的所需。
We will not lose out anything by, you know, gathering before God and to worship Him.
那我们呢，不会在我们就是在收集的事上呢，因为要来敬拜他呢而损失什么。
In fact, the Bible tells us that, you know, He will bless us even more.
其实圣经上告诉我们呢，我们神其实会更加的来祝福我们。
For today's service, I'm going to continue with our subject, our topic on cast upon the Lord.
那今天我想要来继续这个主题，献给主。
We understand that our Lord is a faithful God.
我们知道呢，神呢是一个忠实的神。
He does not lie.
他不来说谎。
Whatever he has said will surely come to pass.
那他所说的每一句话呢，都必来成就。
We have been told that we can cast our sorrow, our worries, and our burden upon him.
那我们呢，可以将我们的重担、我们的忧愁、烦恼都来卸给神。
Because God is more than willing to bear our burdens and our sorrows.
因为神是非常愿意承担我们这些忧愁跟忧虑。
We find that this is like a promise in the Bible.
这就像是圣经当中的应许。
This is a continuous promise.
而且是这个持续实行的应许。
As long as we have burden, we are free to come before Him and cast it upon the Lord.
那只要我们有感到负担的时候呢，我们都能够到神的面前将这个卸给他。
We did mention that, you know, on Wednesday night, there are two principles we have to abide by.
那我们在星期三晚上呢，有提到呢，有两个原则我们要来做到。
According to Jeremiah chapter 31,
根据耶利米书第31章。
We must come close to God. We must climb to the top of Mount Zion.
那我们要来亲近神，要来这个到这个锡安山的顶端。
Because when we are close to God, then He shall turn our sorrow to joy.
那当我们来亲近神，他就会将我们的忧愁转为喜乐。
Because if God is with us, we have the courage and wisdom to face the world today.
那如果神跟我们同在呢，我们就有这样子的这个智慧跟勇气呢，来面对世界上的一切。
We have the courage and strength, you know, to face every challenge that comes our way.
那我们有这样子勇气呢，还有智慧呢，能够来面对所有的这些挑战跟问题。
So we must be close to God, and this is a daily pursuit that we must not ignore.
那所以我们就是要来亲近神，这件事是我们每一天日日都要来追求，要来做的。
The second principle is that the Lord in Matthew chapter 11 is like has extended his invitation to all those who are heavy laden to come to him.
那在马太福音十一章告诉我们呢，他呢就担重担的人都可以到他面前来。
And he obviously he is more than happy to shoulder our burden.
那他愿意来负担我们的这些重担。
Again, there is a condition that we must fulfill.
那一样有一个这个条件我们要来做到。
That is, we must emulate, we must learn you from Jesus to be meek and humble.
就是要学习像耶稣一样这样子温柔跟谦卑。
Sometimes we realize that, you know, we have burdens, we have worries in the heart is because we are not meek and we are not humble before man and God.
有时候发现我们有这个重担，有时候我们忧愁，是因为我们在人面前没有这样的温柔跟谦卑。
Many of the burdens, you know, actually come from our, you know, relationship with others.
那很多的这样子的重担呢，都是我们跟人之间的关系造成的。
We find that, that if we can be meek and humble, then, you know, practically we can resolve every problem.
那如果我们温柔又谦卑呢，其实呢，在很多事上呢，就会来，就不会有这样子的问题产生。
So you find that learning the meekness and the humility of Christ is actually a way to cast our burden upon the Lord.
那所以就可以看到了，来学习基督的温柔谦卑呢，就是我们能够将这个重担来解决的其中一个方法。
If we do not, you know, follow the example of Christ, you find that we have to carry the burdens ourselves.
如果我们不来遵照耶稣的这个模范来去做的话呢，我们常常呢就需要来背负自己的重担。
Now in we mentioned an example based on Matthew chapter 6.
那我们在这个马太福音第六章也讲到一个例子。
And we are told that you know we should not be worried for our life.
那我们提到说呢，我们不要为自己的生命来忧愁。
In fact, you know, in chapter 6, Jesus begins to like in a way like rebuke, you know, his disciple.
那其实，在第六章一开始呢，是耶稣来斥责他的门徒。
We can look at verse 30. Verse 30.
我们看三十章三十节。
Chapter 6, verse 30.
马太福音第六章三十节。
Now, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith?
三十节，你们这小信的人啊。野地里的草今天还在，明天就丢在炉里。神还给他这样的装饰，何况你们呢？
And here Jesus says, "You, of little faith."
那这里耶稣说呢，你们这小信的人呐、啊。
Now in the Bible, little faith means unbelief.
那在圣经当中，这个小信指的就是不信。
Because, you know, a person may believe in Jesus, but in his mind, in his behavior, he conducts himself like a Gentile.
那有个人可能相信耶稣呢，可是在他的行为或者他的这个动作上呢，他可能就像这个外邦人一样。
Obviously, a Gentile is one who does not know God.
那当然，外邦人指的就是那些不认识神的人。
If we have adopted a Gentile mindset,
那如果我们有这样外邦人的这样心态，
that obviously will pile the burdens and worries upon ourselves.
那我们就是将这个重担、忧烦放在自己的身上。
Because this kind of mindset is one that is detached from God.
因为这样子的心态呢，是就是没有跟神同在的。
So in order to cast our burden upon the Lord, then we have to first pursue God's kingdoms and righteousness.
那所以我们要将这个忧愁来卸给神呢，首先要来追求神的国、神的义。
You find that in the course of doing that, we actually cast our burden upon the Lord.
我们发现呢，我们这样做呢，其实就是将我们的重担来卸给神。
We sometimes know our own weakness.
那有时候呢，我们会知道自己的软弱。
It's just that we are not willing to change ourselves.
那只是呢，我们不愿意来改变。
So as a result, we pile burdens upon burdens unto ourselves.
那结果呢，就是把一个一个的重担来放在自己的身上。
Now we are going to look at the second example.
那我们来看第二个例子。
We turn to the book of Psalms.
我们来看诗篇。
We turn to the book of Psalms, chapter 55.
55篇。
We read verse 22.
我们看二十二节。
Psalms, chapter 55, verse 22.
诗篇55篇二十二节。
Cast your burden on the Lord, and he shall sustain you. He shall never permit the righteous to be moved. Or to
你要把你的重担卸给耶和华，他必抚养你，他永不叫义人动摇。
This chapter or this Psalms is actually written by David.
那这首诗呢，是大卫所写的。
You find that this Psalm is quite a special psalm because he is talking about, an event that is really has affected him.
那你会发现呢，这一篇很特别，因为呢，这个是他就是他遇到一个事情，然后真正来影响他很重担的。
Now I want you to look at his emotion or his feeling at the time.
那所以我们就来看他的这个情绪，然后他的感受。
And obviously, you know, he was praying to God at the time as well.
那当然，他就是这里，就是他向神的祷告。
I want you to read verse 2.
我们看第二节。
Attend to me and hear me. I am restless in my complaint and mourned noisily.
二节，求你侧耳听我，应允我，我哀叹不安，发声恨哀。
So the reason is in verse 2.3 and 4, because of his enemies, because of their oppressions against him.
那这个原因呢，就是三节、四节，因为他的仇敌，然后来这样子的欺压他。
Now we read verse 4.
我们看四节。
My heart is severely pained within me, and the terrors of death have fallen upon me.
我心在我里面甚是疼痛，使得惊惶临到我身。
You know, to many of us who have studied, the story of David, we might have come to the conclusion that this is like the life of David, and he always suffer.
那如果我们来常常学习这个大卫，然后我们就发现呢，他在很多的时期都是在受苦。
Now here you find that he wanted to like escape, from the situation.
那这就看到他想要从这样的状况当中来逃离。
We can look at verse 6, yeah.
看第六节。
So I said, that I had wings like a dove, I would fly away and be at rest. Indeed, I would. Continue.
我说，但愿我有翅膀像鸽子，我就飞去得享安息。
Verse 7.
是七节。
Indeed, I would wander far off and remain in the wilderness.
我必远游，宿在旷野。
Verse 8.I would hasten my escape from the windy storm and tempest.
我必速速逃到避所，脱离狂风暴雨。
We said, David at this point in time is like he has this mindset of escapism. He wanted to escape reality.
那如果这个时候的这个大卫呢，他就是想要逃离，想要来就是逃离这个事实。
He was a man of God.
我们知道他是神的属神的人。
So on many occasions, he knew how to count on the Lord.
那所以呢，很多时间，他知道怎么样来依靠神。
How is it that on this occasion he wanted to escape it from reality?
那结果为什么这个时候呢，他想要从这个现实来逃离呢？
Because he was facing a great challenge.
因为他面对了很大的挑战。
In a way, it's like unprecedented.
那就是呢，他就是这个重担太重了。
We can look at verse 12, and to verse 14 to understand a bit more about the background.
我们看12到14节，看这个背景是怎么样。
Verse 12. For it is not an enemy who reproaches me that I could bear it, nor is it one who hates me who has exalted himself against me than I could hide from him.
原来不是仇敌辱骂我，若是仇敌还可以忍耐，也不是恨我的人向我狂大，若是恨我的人就必躲避他。
Verse 13. But it was you, a man, my equal, my companion, and my acquaintance.
13. 不料是你，你原与我平等，是我的同伴，是我知己的朋友。
Verse 14.
14.
We took sweet counsel together and walked to the house of God in the throng.
我们素常彼此谈论，以为甘甜。我们与群众在神的殿中同行。
Here he was mentioned someone who was very close to him.
啊，这里提到一个跟他很亲近的人。
And for some reason, this person, you know, turned against him.
啊，因为某个缘故呢，这个人来这样子背叛他。
That's why you can see that he was so much, you know, in pain, you know, in the heart.
啊，就会看到因为这样子呢，他在心中有非常大的这样子的愁烦。
And not only that, if you have read the entire chapter, and this person, it seems that did not want to spare him, you know, with his words.
那如果你这一章来看呢，就发现这个人他不想用这个语言来放过大卫。
So it's like, you know, David was attacked quite badly by the person.
那就是大卫呢，被这个人呢来这个的攻击。
No wonder he wanted to escape, you know, from the situation. He would rather, you know, stay in the wilderness.
啊，难怪呢，他想要来逃离这样的状况，宁愿呢就是留在这个旷野。
So here it teaches us about human relationship issues.
那这就告诉我们这个人际关系的问题。
It teaches us how we can cast you know, this worries and pain upon the Lord.
哦，就是呢，我们怎么样呢，可以将这样子的烦恼跟这样痛苦呢，来卸给神。
This incident here actually makes me, you know,recall, you know, the example of Job.
那这件事情就让我想到这个约伯。
We understand that, you know, after all his children died.
啊，就是在他的儿女呢都过世之后。
Some of his friends, you know, came with an intention of comforting him.
啊，有些他的朋友呢，就带着想要来安慰他的心呢，来这边。
But you find that, you know, his friend ended up, you know, like accusing him of sinning against God.
啊，但是结果呢，这些朋友呢，来控告他说呢，来犯罪得罪神了。
Now we are going to look at some example given in the book of Job.
那我们就来看约伯记的这个例子。
We turn to chapter 5.
我们看第五章。
Chapter 5, yeah.
第五章
We know that from chapter 4 to 5, our words are spoken by his friend Eliphaz.
我们知道四章五章都是他的朋友以利法说的。
Now we read verse 4.
我们看四节。
His sons are far from safety, they are crushed in the gates, and there is no deliverer.
他的儿女远离稳妥的地步，在城门被压，并无人搭救。
Now we can also read verse 17.
我们也看十七节。
Behold, happy is the man whom God corrects. Therefore, do not despise the chastening of the Almighty.
其实只能说诚挚的人是有福的，所以你不可轻看全能者的管教。
For he bruises, but he binds up. He wounds, but he hands make whole.
因为他打破又缠裹，他击伤用手医治。
You find it from these words. You know the words themselves are not the.Incorrect.
那但是你仔细来看他的话呢，说的其实不是不正确的。
But you know the word, however, the words did not reflect the true situation that Job was in.
那可是这样子的，就是他的话呢，却没有反映出约伯的真实的状况。
It's like you know they were trying to help Job without knowing the true reasons.
那就是他们就在不知情的这个状况下呢，想要来帮助他。
And therefore, you know, they came up with a lot of ideas, you know.
然后就有很多的，就是他们的想法出来。
And you know, trying to like place it upon a job and see job, this is what you have done.
然后就把他们的想法来放在约伯身上，说，哎，约伯，这个就是你的状况。
Because your children have sinned, and therefore, and this happened to you.
啊，因为的儿女犯罪，所以这样的事情临到你的身上。
I want you to look at chapter 8 as well.
那我们也来看第八章。
Here it mentioned about other friends by the name Bildad.
那这是他另外一个朋友比勒达说的。
We read verse 4.
我们看四节。
If your sons have sinned against him, he has cast them away for their transgression.
或者你的儿女得罪了他，他使他们受报应。
If you would earnestly seek God and make your supplication to the Almighty,
你若殷勤的寻求神，向全能者恳求。
And it's like saying to Job, yeah, your son sinned against God, and therefore God cast them away.
那就像他们对这个约伯说，哦，是你的这个儿女犯罪呢，所以神呢要这样子来惩罚他们。
You can imagine the pain that Job endured.
啊，你可以想一下这个约伯他心中的这样子的痛苦。
You know, for someone to lose his son is already bad enough.
那就想象一个人已经失去他的儿女，已经非常的糟了。
He lost all the children.
那而且他的全部的儿女都失丧了。
And here the friend came and said something which is not edifying at all.
那但是呢，这个他们朋友来说的话是一点都没有帮助。
It's like trying to judge, you know, Job.
啊，很像在这个审判约伯一样。
That's why, you know, Job even said that he could not control himself but to speak.
那所以呢，约伯才说呢，我控制不了他，必须要来说开口说话。
That's why, you know, in the book, you can see how Job, you know, described his friends.
那所以就可以在约伯记中呢，来看到他怎么形容他的朋友。
Let's look at a number of examples. Yeah.
那我们再看几个例子。
We took a look at chapter 13.
我们看十三章。
Verse 4.
第四节。
Chapter 13, verse 4.
十三章第四节。
But you forgers of lies, you are all worthless physicians.
你们是编造谎言的，都是无用的医生。
We can also read chapter 16.
也看十六章。
We read verse 2.
二节。
I have heard many such things, miserable comforters are you all.
这样的话我听了许多，你们安慰人反叫人愁烦。
Oh, miserable in another translation is like pathetic, you know, comforters.
那这个愁烦另外一个
comforters
就是呢很悲惨，很可怜。
So here you find that, you know, this is how you know,Job was so much pressured by his friends.
那就是呢，约伯被他的朋友呢施压了很多很多的压力。
First, they did not know exactly what had happened to Job.
那首先，他们并不明白那个发生在约伯身上的原因是什么。
Because something spiritual had happened to him, you know, there had been exchanges between God and Satan in heaven.
那因为呢，有属灵的事情，有这个魔鬼跟这个神的这个对话。
They didn't understand what was going on.
那他们并不明白这个原因理由。
And they came along is like they presented themselves like judges before a Job.
那他们就来到他这个约伯的面前，把自己当成这个判官。
Did that actually help Job?
啊，这个对约伯有帮助吗？
Not at all.
一点都没有。
So with this understanding, when you look at the example of David.
那所以有这个例子之外，然后我们来看大卫。
Then we understand why he wanted to escape.
你就可以知道说为什么他想要逃离。
Because his close friends has turned against him.
因为他的亲密的朋友呢来背叛了他。
So here what can we learn?
那这里我们学到什么呢？
Now obviously, you know, the verse that we have read is we must cast our burden upon the Lord.
那刚刚我们读到经节就是呢，我们要将所有的这个忧虑来卸给神。
We turn back to Psalms chapter 55.
我们看回来诗篇五十五篇。
We read verse 22.
二十二节。
Cast your burden on the Lord, and He shall sustain you. The English says sustain you.
那二十二节说，你要把你的重担卸给神，他必抚养你。英文说是呢，要来就是来保全你。
You know, if David did not cast his burden upon the Lord, then he will surely be defeated.
那如果呢，他没有把这个忧虑献给神，他一定就会被这个事情来打败。
Now, you know, the lesson that we can gather from here is that, you know, in order to cast our burden upon the Lord, first, we must examine ourselves.
所以呢，要把这个圣诞卸给，首先呢，我们要来反省自己。
Sometimes, you know, words spoken against us may contain some elements of truth.
那有时候呢，对我们说的这些话语呢，其实会有包含某个程度的这个真实的内容。
So, you know, sometimes we hear words of attacks against us.
那所以我们有时候听到别人用话来攻击我们。
There may be some elements of truth.
那可能有部分的这个是真实的。
So if we can recognize that,
所以我们能够呢看到那一点。
Then we will not be too angry.
我们就不会就是大发烈怒。
Because after all, you know, what has been said, is not a complete reflection of who we are, but at least there is some elements of truth in it.
因为说这样子的话，并不是说我们的人就真的是这样子，但是呢，可能有某部分的我们真的是像他所形容的。
Now, the second thing that we need to do is like follow the example of David to pray to God.
那第二个步骤就是呢，像大卫一样来向神祷告。
You know, and to ask God, you know, to help, to, you know, to strengthen.
那求神要来帮助他，然后来给他力量。
And I think verse 22 also give us another answer to the problem.
那第22节告诉我们另外一个这个问题的原因。
In fact, you find that David, you know, knew how to be sustained by God.
其实呢，大卫知道要怎么样被神抚养，就是被神来就是保守。
Because the last part is saying he shall never permit the righteous to be moved.
他说呢，最后一节说他永不叫义人动摇。
So you know, as long as we remain righteous in the eyes of God.
只要我们在神面前是成为义人的话。
Meaning to do what is right in the eyes of God.
那就是行神眼中看为义的事。
Then we shall never be moved.
那我们就必不被动摇。
When we feel that we are being attacked.
如果我们觉得被攻击了。
Then we have to pray for, you know, those who attack us.
那我们就要为那些攻击我们的人来祷告。
We turn to Psalms, chapter 35.
我们看诗篇35篇。
Here it records another example, David has been through before.
那这里记载另外一件大卫所经历的事情。
I want you to read from verse 12.
我们从十二节开始看。
Chapter 35, verse 12.
35篇十二节。
They reward me evil for good to the sorrow of my soul.
他们向我以恶报善，使我的灵魂孤苦。
Verse 13.
13。
But as for me, when they were sick, my clothing was sackcloth. I humbled myself with fasting, that my prayer would return to my own heart.
至于我，当他们有病的时候，我便穿麻衣，进食，刻苦己心，我所求的都归到自己的怀中。
Verse 14.
14节。
I paced about as though he were my friends or brother. I bowed down heavily as one who mourns for his mother.
14节，我这样行，好像他是我的朋友，我的弟兄，我屈身悲哀，如同人为母亲哀痛。
So you find that, you know, David actually had experienced a lot of sufferings in life.
那去看到这个大卫呢，其实生命中遇到很多的这个痛苦的事。
But, you know, the way he responded, you know, to each situation is worthy of our emulation.
但是他面对这些苦难的时候所做的反应呢，是值得我们来学习的。
So, you know, and it's like he prayed for these people.
那就是呢，看到他为这些人来祷告。
You find that, you know, by merely escaping from the situation will not help resolve the issue.
那我们知道呢，如果从这个问题的这个现实呢来逃离，其实并不会来解决这个问题。
Sometimes we hear, you know, people said, you know, please leave me alone, you know, give me time, that kind of thing.
那有时候你会听到人家说，哦，就是不要管我，给我一些时间等等的这些事情。
Or, a person in suffering would always want to, you know, depart, you know, from the situation that he is in.
那或是呢，那个受苦的人就会想要逃离呢，他就是让他痛苦的这件事情。
And we understand that this does not really help.
那我们知道说，其实这样做并不会有所帮助。
Why is it so?
那为什么这样呢？
Because of lingering thoughts in our mind.
那就是因为我们心中的这样子的，就是那个意念跟那个愁烦。
So if we do not, inject, if I can say, yeah, inject positivity into our mindset, then we will always remain negative.
那就是说呢，如果我们没有把有正面的这个意念呢注射在我们的脑中呢，我们这样的负面都还是存在的。
And we can be far away from a person whom we do not like.
那我们可以就是跟不喜欢的人，然后离得很远很远。
But our mind may not be able to detach from the person.
那可是我们的心思其实还是没办法从那个人身上来抽离。
So how can we cast our burden unto the Lord?
那我们要怎么把忧虑卸给神呢？
So the best way is to pray for the person.
那第一个最重要就是呢，为那个人来祷告。
So if we can bring ourselves to pray for the person concerned,
那如果我们自己能够来为那个人来的事情呢来祷告。
You find that all the negative feelings, you know, all the unpleasant feelings, feeling within will begin to disappear.
那就发现呢，我们的这个内在的不舒服的情绪呢，这些负面的想法呢，就会消失。
So this is how we can cast, you know, our sorrow and our burden unto the Lord.
那我们就能够这样子将我们的愁烦忧虑呢来卸给神。
Now we're going to look at another example.
那我们再看另外一个例子。
We turn to First Peter.
我们看彼得前书。
We turn to First Peter chapter 5.
彼得前书第五章。
First Peter chapter 5.
彼得前书第五章。
We look at verse 7.
我们看七节。
Chapter 5, verse 7.
五章七节。
Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you.
你们要将一切的忧虑卸给神，因为他顾念你们。
Here, Peter, you know, is writing, you know, to the diaspora Jews, those who are scattered in Asia Minor in times of persecution.
那这个彼得呢，是像这个信呢，就是写给那些当时呢，所以是散落在这个之前很多地方的这些信徒。
So to encourage them to stand firm, yeah, in Asia Minor, 小亚细亚哈, to stand firm, in their faith.
啊，让他们在这个小亚细亚的人呢，在信仰上能够站立得稳。
Now when you look at verse 6, yeah,
我们看第六节。
And therefore humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that He may exalt you in due time.
所以你们要自卑伏在神大能的手下，到的时候他必叫你们升高。
Verse 6 is talking about humbling oneself, yeah, before God.
那六节告诉我们呢，在神面前要来是自卑。
Now the question is, how is that related, yeah, to casting our cares and concern upon the Lord?
那这个跟就是把忧虑卸给神，然后把忧愁卸给神有什么相关呢？
Now when you look at this chapter, especially this section of the scriptures, we understand.You know, the setting is like a setting of the community.
那如果你看这一章，特别是这一段呢，发现了这个呢，就是在讲他们那个团体。
I mean the church, community. Yeah.
那就是指的这个教会。
You know, we all desire the church to grow and to expand.
那我们都希望教会成长，教会来扩张。
And so that you know, the name of God can be glorified.
要让神的名能够来得荣耀。
And we also desire more souls that can be saved.
那我们也更希望更多的灵魂能够得救。
We all understand that the unity of the church is of utmost importance.
那我们知道教会当中的团结合一呢是最重要的事。
Satan seeks to divide.
那撒旦想要来就是来分裂。
A genuine worker of God seeks to unite.
但是呢，这个神真神的工人呢，是要来让教会来团结合一。
Because what he cares about is the unity and the prosperity of the church.
因为他们顾念的就是呢，教会的合一，还有教会的这个成长。
So you can see, you know, the like in Peter, you know, just like Peter here, he does care for the church so much.
所以看到这就像彼得一样，他也非常的关心教会。
He was in his advanced age.
那他这个年纪已经很大了。
But what he cares about is, is the well-being, the spiritual well-being of the church.
可是他非常注重的关心这教会这个属灵的这个程度。
We look at verse 5.
我们看第五节。
Likewise, you younger people, submit yourself to your elders. Yes, all of you be submissive to one another and be clothed with humility. For God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble.
五节，你们年幼的也要顺服年长的，就是你们众人也要以谦卑束腰彼此顺服，因为神阻挡骄傲的人，神赐恩给谦卑的人。
Peter here, you know, has put in place a proper order in the church.
那这里呢，彼得来告诉这个教会的这个次序应该是怎么样？
So the younger people must submit to the elders.
所以年幼的要来顺服年长的。
This is the order, yeah.
那这是一个次序。
But it does not mean that, you know, the elderly, you know, can do what they want.
那并不是说这个年长的就可以随意做他们想要的。
So an elderly person must also learn to submit to one another.
那这个年长的也要学习顺服彼此。
This is how the church should function.
那这是教会应该要有的这样子的这个规律。
Meaning that the entire church must be clothed with humility.
就是说呢，整个教会呢都要以谦卑来束腰。
So if the church is humble,
before, 教会里的人大家都顺服。
You find that you know the church will experience the abiding presence of God.
你就发现了教会呢会能够来体验神的同在。
It also goes to show that you know all of us have submitted ourselves humbly before God.
那也会展现出说教会的每个人都是自己 来顺服神的。
We are under the mighty hands of the Lord. We are being in, you know, looked after by God.
那我们都是在神的大能手之下来被神来看顾的。
So if the church can function in this manner with a spirit of humility,
如果呢教会呢都能够 以这个谦卑来这样子来运行。
You find that, you know, it's like saying that the church has cast all her burden unto the Lord.
那就很像说呢，教会将所有的就是忧虑呢，都来卸给神了。
Because everyone is willing to submit to one another.
因为每一个人呢，都愿意来彼此来顺服。
I think, you know, in our service to the Lord, we all have learned so much about how to deal with our own emotions.
那我们知道在彼此服侍的当中呢，我们都学到要怎么样来处理自己的情绪。
You know, sometimes, you know, our emotion may run high.
有时候我们情绪很高涨。
So to an extent that we are not able to control ourselves very well.
那有时候呢，我们这个控制不了自己的情绪。
And that will create a lot of burden and worries in the heart.
那就造成了我们的心中呢，产生很多的这个忧虑，有这样子的重担。
So when we begin to learn, you know, to humble ourselves before God and man.
所以当我们来学习在人在神面前来谦卑。
You find that there is no cares or concern in the heart.
就发现心中就没有再没有这样的忧愁跟忧虑了。
Because in the process, we have already entrusted all things unto the hands of the Lord.
因为在这个过程中，我们已经将所有的忧愁呢都交给神了。
We also find that only in this state of mind, then the church can become vigilant.
只有当大家的心态都是这样调整过之后呢，才能够有一个警醒的心。
So we can, you know, we can resist, you know, the work of Satan in the church.
那我们才能够来抵挡这个魔鬼在教会的工作。
We can read verse 8 and verse 9, yeah?
我们也读八节九节。
First Peter chapter 5, verse 8 and verse 9.
彼得前书五章八到九节。
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour.
勿要谨守警醒，因为你们的仇敌魔鬼如同吼叫的狮子，遍地游行，寻找可吞吃的人。
Verse 9.
九节。
Resist him steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world.
你们要坚固的信心来抵挡他，因为你知道你们在世上的众弟兄也是经历这样的苦难。
We have been told time and again that we need to stay alert and need to be vigilant in our faith.
那我们常常被提醒说呢，要在我们信仰当中也要来谨守警醒。
Because our adversary is, you know, prowling around like a lion, yeah? Waiting to devour, you know, those whom he can devour.
因为我们的仇敌魔鬼就像这个吼叫的狮子在寻找可以吞吃的人。
And you find that when there is no humility in the church,
如果教会当中没有谦卑,
So we will become the prey of Satan.
那我们就变成这个撒旦的就是这个目标。
When there is no humility, you find that we'll fight against one another.
如果没有谦卑的话, 我们甚至会彼此来攻击。
And if that is the case, how can we stay vigilant against Satan?
那如果这样的话, 怎么又能够来警醒, 来对抗魔鬼呢?
We spend our time on, you know, on fighting against ourselves.
那时间 花在就是内部的这个斗争了。
So, we said, you know, it's very energy sapping, you know, drain our energy away.
那就是这样子就已经就是把我们的这个能量全部都已经就是用光了。
How can we stand firm against Satan?
那哪有还有能量能够来对抗这个撒旦?
So we must have a correct mindset, you know, in our service to God.
所以我们在这个服事的时候有一个很正确的心态。
That is, we must learn to submit under the authority of God.
就是要来学着来顺服神的这个大权、权能。
You find that when the church is united,
你发现如果教会是合一的,
There's no way that Satan can cause or inflict a wound or harm to us.
那撒旦其实是没有办法对我们来造成任何的伤害。
Sometimes we see the work of Satan in the church.
有时候我们看到这个撒旦在教会的这些工作。
Simply because we have given ground to Satan to work in us.
那其实是因为呢，我们首先将这个就是给撒旦留地步了。
So we must be very careful.
所以我们要十分的注意。
So, and also in this way, you know, with humility, then we can cast, you know, our burden upon the Lord.
还有呢，这个这样子的，就是谦卑呢，我们能够将我们的重担卸给神。
We look at one more verse, yeah.
那我们再看一节。
We turn to Philippians chapter 4.
我们看腓立比书第四章。
Philippians chapter 4.
腓立比书第四章。
We read verse 6.
第六节。
Chapter 4, verse 6.
四章六节。
Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God.
应当一无挂虑，只要凡事借着祷告、祈求和感谢，将你们所要的告诉神。
Verse 7.
七节。
And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
神所赐出人意外的平安，必在基督耶稣里保守你们的心怀意念。
These are the words spoken by Paul to the members in Philippi.
这是保罗对这个腓立比的人所说的。
And, you know, saying to them not to be anxious, you know, for anything.
告诉他们应当一无挂虑。
So must learn to pray to God.
要学着来向神祷告。
And trust all things unto the hand of the Lord.
然后呢，将所有的东西呢，都来交托在神的手中。
But we know that this is not easy to do.
但是我们也知道这是不是件容易的事情。
But in verse 5, you know, again, there is a very important point that we can learn from.
可是第五节告诉我们一个很重要的这个重点。
Let your gentleness be known to all men, the Lord is at hand.
当叫众人知道你们谦让的心，主已经近了。
So you find that, you know, this example that Christ has shown in terms of gentleness must be adopted by us in our life.
耶稣呢，所为我们示范这样子温柔谦卑的心，我们要一样的去做。
And you find that, you know, a person, if he has a heart of gentleness, even his prayer, yeah, you know, can be easily accepted by God.
那当一个人有谦卑温柔，他的祷告呢就会被神来悦纳。
We find that he can easily cast his burden upon the Lord.
我们就可以发现呢，他能够将他的这个重担来交给神。
So on the contrary, if someone does not have humility,
相反的，如果一个人没有谦卑，
it's very difficult for the person to pray even before God.
那这个人呢，要在神面前就是要祷告呢，也是一件困难的事。
He may pray to God, but you find that in reality, he is not really praying to God.
那他像是在祷告，但是呢，他其实没有来向神来祷告的。
Because the mindset is not right before the Lord.
因为他的心态在神面前就是错误的。
So we must, learn from this example here.
那所以我们要学习这里的这个教训。
And always cultivate ourselves to be gentle and to be gracious and forbearing towards others.
那我们要学着来谦卑温柔，然后能够来感激，然后来能够来原谅别人。
In this way, we can easily cast our burdens unto the Lord in prayers.
那如果真的这样做的话，我们就能够很容易的将我们的重担来卸给主。
My service ends here.
那我的这个讲道到这边结束。
We sing a hymn to praise God.
我们唱诗祷告神，赞美神。
263.
我们唱诗263首。
Please rise.
请起立。